or make the wrong interpretation. And that's why I formed CAGI, because many of us working together and digging and searching for information are much more likely not to make the mistakes than one man working alone. Let's go back now to the beginning, when man was in his infancy on the evolutionary scale of development. Man was alone. Alone in the sense that he did not have all of the help and the knowledge that we have today that enables us to survive. You see, man then was subject to the cold, to the wild beasts of prey. He didn't have a home, didn't have air conditioning in the summer, didn't have heating in the winter, didn't have medical doctors. If he became ill or injured, he was most likely to die. So it did not take ancient man very long to decide that in this world the single greatest enemy to be feared was the darkness of night and all the unknown dangers that came with it. And simply stated, man's first enemy was darkness. Now, understanding this one fact alone, one can readily see why the greatest and most trustworthy friend the human race could ever have at that time was, by far, heaven's greatest gift to the world, that glorious rising orb of day that we call the sun. And that was the beginning of the battle between light and darkness. And it was man's first understanding of the death and the rebirth of a deity. For the sun rose, was born in the morning, traveled across the heavens, where it reached its most powerful point, the zenith, and that will explain why so many things occur at noon or near noon, and then signifying old age and the end of its life, sank into the west and then died. And man was subjected to the rigors and the dangers and the cold of night, until his God again was reborn the next morning. Now, folks, I'm not making any of this up, and it took me many, many years of study to figure this out. Man noticed that the moon also rose, lived a different life than the sun, and then set and died and was reborn again. The sun, because of its brilliance, became the master or the greatest deity. And the moon took on the feminine aspect because the moon reflected the light of her master. And all of this will begin to make sense to you eventually as we go through this, because from now on every program that I do is going to be devoted to this, to the explanation of the esoteric religion, the ancient mystery religion. and it's important that we all understand it because these are the people in charge. And don't ask me to tell you the truth of religion, for I really believe in the Constitution and that we all have a right to worship our own God in our own way. And no one has the right to tell anyone, unless asked, what they should believe. You all know by now that I am a Christian. But I'm not a Christian in the sense that I follow the dogma of any church or the preachings of any preacher or necessarily, word for word, the Bible. I stick strictly and only to those words that are directly attributed to Jesus Christ, and I attempt to follow those words in my daily life. And it doesn't matter to me whether anyone proves that he never lived or that he lived or not. I have found that those are the most profound teachings amongst all of the books and teachings that I have ever heard or read in my entire life. And until someone can prove to me that there is something better, that is what I will always adhere to. I do not advise you what you should believe or not believe. But I do advise you that we all need to learn as much as we can about everything that we can, because one thing I have learned in my life is that most of what we have ever been taught has been a lie. And that whoever these people are, and I know who they are, and I will impart that knowledge to you, who are the priests, the adepts, and the initiates, and the mystery schools, they are in control, and they are shaping the future, and that future will affect all of us, so we had better learn as much about them as we can. You cannot identify an enemy unless you know the enemy, and you cannot fight a battle if you know nothing about the battle tactics of your opponent. And when you understand that Lucifer is the sun of the morning star, or the morning star itself, then the creations of the members of the mystery school begin to make much more sense. Good night, and God bless you all.